Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Civil Engineering Academy. My name's Cody. Let's go ahead and get started. So today we have a project management problem. It's going to be a scheduling problem, and it wants us to solve for the critical path. Basically, I mean, you can go through the options here. It says draw an activity on node critical path, indicate the critical path, what's the earliest finish, what's the late finish, and then I plan to explain what float is. We're given a table here with the activity, the predecessors, the successors, and the duration. We're given the, you know, all our nodes that we're going to be using. So you have to start with start. And by the way, we are in section 2.4 of the PE handbook. So if you want to follow along, you can look at that. So you have to start, and then from start, you go to a node. And that node is going to be A. So the duration is going to be 7 for A. If you're looking at activity A, its predecessors start, its successors B, C, D, and the duration for A is 7. So we're going to write 7. So now we have to do something called early start, early finish, late start, late finish. Our early start for A is going to be on day 0, right? That's the earliest that it can start. The earliest it can finish is on day 7, and this will make sense here in a minute. Because it's 7, you know, 7 days long. That's how long it's going to take activity A to complete. We're not even going to worry about late yet. That's for our backwards pass. So now what we're doing right now is called a forward pass. And basically it means we're moving forward. We're starting at the start and we're going to the finish. Backwards pass is the exact opposite. That's kind of where you're going to find your float. So we can go ahead and draw our nodes here. We're going to go to B, C, D now. So I'm going to write B, C, and D. Okay, so B lasts for 6 days, C lasts for 5 days, D lasts for 7 days, or sorry, 2 days. 2 days, and A goes to D, A goes to C, and A goes to B. All right, those are awful arrows there, but we get the point. So now we have to find our earliest start for B, C, and D, and it's exactly what you think it is. It's going to be 7 because B can't start until A is finished. The soonest A can get finished is on day 7. The soonest that B can get started is on day 7. Same thing for C, same thing for D. Since B is 6 days long, it's going to have 13 be its early finish. And then for C, it's 5 days long, so its early finish is going to be 12. For D, it's going to last 2 days. Its early finish is going to be 9. So B goes to G. Let's go ahead and draw our G. C goes to E and F. And D goes to F. All right, so simple enough. We can draw our arrows now. This guy goes to that guy and that guy. B goes to G. Okay, so the soonest that G can start is on day 13. We're going to go ahead and lose the table here. All right, so the soonest that E can start is on day 12 because it's dependent on when C gets finished. So as far as F goes, it has two contributing factors. It has C and it has D. Its earliest start is going to be on day 12. And the reason why is because F cannot start until D and C are completed. So its earliest start is 12. So now we have to check our times. So let's see G, E, and F. G is 11, E 13, F 4. This earliest finish is going to be 24. E's earliest finish is 25. Oops, looks like I forgot to write the times down. G is 11 days. That'll help. E is 13 days. F is 4 days. So since F's 14 or 4 days, it's going to be 16 as its earliest finish. So what comes after G? It's looking like H What comes after E, H, and then H goes to finish? What goes after F, I, and then I goes to finish? So we have H and I. And H is going to last for 6 days. I is going to last for 5 days. That goes to that. That goes to that. That goes to that. So the earliest that H can start is on day 25. The reason why is because it needs G and E before it can start. So we're going to start with 25 for H. And then it's 6 days long, so we can go ahead and write 31. And then for I, we have an early start of 16, early finish of 21. And both of these go to finish. What is our earliest finish? It's 31. And the reason why is because we cannot finish our project until both H and I are completed. So our earliest finish equals 31. And the way that we're going to do our backwards pass is we're going to use that same 31 but work backwards to find our float, to check our work, and I'll explain that here in a minute. So our late finish is 31. So we have 31 here, 31 here. What's 31 minus 6? I'm glad you asked, it's 25. All right, what's 31 minus 5? 26. So now then, we're split again. So we have G and we have E, but those guys are very influential on the completion of H. So our earliest finish for those, or latest finish, sorry, our latest finish for both of those guys are going to be 25, because once day 25 hits, H can begin. So this is 25. This is 25. So, and F, or latest finish, can be day 26. Cool. So 25 minus 11, that's going to be 14. That's going to be 12. F, 26 minus 4 is 22. D, the earliest finish, or the latest finish, can be day 22. And it's 2 days long, so this means day 20. So that means day 20 is going to be your late start for D. So now for C, we have a 22. And we have a 12. We are going to use 12. And the reason why is because we can, the latest that we can finish to keep this thing on track for E and F is day 12. And by that, you have a 10 days gap between C and F on when F can stay on track, right? So that's why it's 12. So, 12 minus 5, you're going to be looking at 7. And we got B here. B, the earliest finish, is 14. 14 minus 6 for B is 8. So now then, what is our latest finish for A? It's going to be 7. So now then, what is our latest start? Day 0. And we can already kind of see a pattern. We see some matching. So to find your critical path, it's basically where your early start, your early finish, your late start, and your late finish are the same numbers. So in this case, we start at start. In this case, we start at start. We have A, we have C, we have E, H, and then to the finish. That is our critical path right there. So it's this guy. And it wants us to know what's the earliest finish, the latest finish. We have it right there, 31. And then as far as float goes, here's a good lesson on float. Let's use F, for example. If you're looking at F, node F, the earliest that it can start is day 12. The latest it can start is day 22. So it has about a 10-day gap before it has to get started, before it delays the project. That's going to be your float for this problem.